Blessed morning to all of you, my dear brothers and sisters. Narito po tayo muli upang magdiwang bilang isang pamilya at magpasalamat sa Diyos sa panibagong linggo at magpasalamat sa mga biyayang natanggap po natin noong mga nakaraang araw. And as we celebrate this 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time, let me at least take you a little back to what we have sung and responded a while ago with our responsorial song. And we all said and prayed, the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. Ang kaloob at kaluguran natin ay nasa loobin ng Diyos. At ano bang ang mga loobin na ito ng Diyos? What were these precepts of the Lord that gave joy to the heart in the readings we have all heard today? In our first reading from the book of Numbers, we've heard how the Lord gave or shared the spirit of Moses to the hearts of 70 wise men. At bakit po nagbahagi ng espiritu at ng responsibilidad ang Diyos sa mga lalaking ito? Just a little background. This story was at least a jumping board from the experience of Israel from their slavery. Nagrereklamo na ang mga tao, and I think we've all heard that some 2 months ago, how they were all complaining to Moses, pinakain mo kami ng tinapay na ito, ginugutom mo kami sa disyerto na ito. And the precepts of the Lord gave joy to them by the Lord giving them men who will assure them of God's goodness, of men who will take note of them that indeed there is life and there is hope. And how was this precepts that give joy to the heart also present in our gospel for today? We've heard how a certain person was, in the name of Jesus, was able to free someone from the spirit of the evil one. Kung papaanong sa pamamagitan ni Jesus ay nakapagpalaya siya sa isang kadiliman ng buhay. But take note, John told Jesus that this man was not following us. Hindi natin siya kabaro. Pagbawalan mo siya dahil hindi natin siya kasama at ginagamit niya pa marahil ang pangalan mo para makapagpalayas ng kasamaan. But Jesus told them, do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. And Jesus followed it with some ways. How will God's goodness give joy to the heart? To anyone who gives a cup of water to drink because he is a disciple will surely not lose his reward. And we've heard some ways as well how God's goodness will give joy to the heart when we are reminded as well how our own bodies can also affect and lead us to sin. And my dear brothers and sisters, this is one thing that we all wish to open our eyes with. Every day, God's precepts, God's will, and God's goodness will always give us joy in our hearts. Kung bakit tayo marahil unti-unting sinasaktan ng salita ng Diyos na napapakinggan natin, hindi lang po marahil para kurutin ang inyong mga pusong matigas, kundi para maging maligaya din ang puso po ninyo. why you are blessed today, why you are still alive and kicking this day, because God wants you to have that joy in your heart. Why you continue to enjoy your blessings everywhere and then, because that is just a manifestation how God wants you to have that joy in your heart. At kung papaanong ang Diyos ay gustong magkaroon tayo ng kaluguran at kaligayahan sa puso natin, please then share that joy to one another's heart. Be that disciple who will be that courageous enough to at least share a cup of water. And that cup of water can be a lot of ways today. Your inspiration, your presence, your generosity, your time, your being faithful to your responsibility as a parent, as someone who guides everyone, that will certainly give joy to the heart of many. Kagabi po ay nagdaos po ang ating Manila Cathedral Choir ng kanilang Thanksgiving concert. Matapos po ang ilang buwan ng kanilang pag-eensayo and ongoing formation and training para maging mas magagaling pa po silang mga choir members, they all gathered here and presented some songs to maybe most of you who may be here or to a lot of you who may have watched them via online. No, nasa page po yung concert kagabi. No, kung gusto nyo pong maaliw, pakinggan po ninyo yung mga kanta nila. And I am very sure that their own training, their own perseverance, their voices gave joy to the heart, to the hearts of many. Marahil madaming nakikinig lang kagabi na gusto lang ay mapakinggan ang kanilang mga tinig, pero ang kanilang mga kinanta ay nagbaon ng pag-asa sa kanilang puso. Pagkanta lang po yan, pero kita niyo po kung papaanong ako at ang madaming nakapakinig dito ay nakapagbiyaya din ng kaligayahan sa aming mga puso. If today is a weekday, every 29th of September, we always remember the feasts of the archangels Gabriel, Michael, and Raphael. And these three archangels brought not only to the people of the New and Old Testament and also to us God's joys in our hearts. When Michael freely defended his people from Satan, when Gabriel brought the gospel and the good news to Mary, when Raphael became God's healing, such things gave joy to the hearts of many. My beloved brothers and sisters, let us remind ourselves that as how God would continue to show His goodness, God would continue to give joy to our hearts. And let us remind ourselves that you are blessed, you are gifted, you are loved, so that you can also give joy to the hearts of many. Huwag na po tayong dumagdag sa magpapasakit ng ulo at puso ng madami. So that at every day, as you see that person, as you embrace another day with people around you, as you continue to hear inspiration, encouragement, and the support from people, we can always say that with these people, with those experiences, I know that God's goodness will continue to give joy to our hearts.